Howdy, Wayo, Russ here.
And Chris.
Our buddy actually told us about this song. So
Nathan.
He said it was a little risque.
He said it was risque.
But he used different terms. Oh, we do have a cameo now. So if you want like an individualized shout out from us, be creative.
Yes.
And we're cheap.
Yes. The first cameo we did, we had to belch on film.
We're cheap just like Miley Cyrus.
Ooh.
I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
You did not.
I really, truly am kidding. People can hopefully take a joke.
Okay, I've got a broken ear. Broken earbuds and broken glasses.
While he's figuring out that, please subscribe for a while, Russ. We want our subscribers to go up, 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 up. Also hit that notification bell because that's how YouTube works. And if you do not hit that bell, you won't know of our video.
Okay. So let me get my eyes on. Let me get my ears in.
I think we're going to have to write it, like, seriously make a shirt that says, like, old man syndrome. Because you definitely have old man syndrome. Let's get right into it. This is Miley Cyrus, Mother's Daughter. Every woman
is a riot. She does that tongue action. That's just kind of like...
It's kind of erotic.
It's erotic.
What does that
it's
actually like, look like?
Two of them rubbing together, and you can't do that too well like that.
Mm-hmm. What's that called when something looks like something else? And it looks dirty, but it's really something like ordinary?
Those are just ordinary balloons.
When I think of Miley Cyrus, like the first thought I have is her like, she loves that tongue. Like, you've seen Wrecking Ball, right?
Well.
how long is her tongue? Maybe we should pause it real quick. Ah! It's pretty normal.
It's not as long as, what's the guy with Kiss?
Gene Simmons,
yeah. It's not as long as Gene Simmons' tongue.
Maxi pad.
Panty liner. Hallelujah. I'm a freak, I'm a freak,
hallelujah. Every day of the week, I'm a do ya. Like I want to. So hallelujah, she's a freak. So she's embracing her inner freak. She's proud of her freak. Because she's going to do ya. Her outfit is very sexy. Isn't there like a fetish?
Is
like
it latex? Is that what it is?
Maybe latex fetish. I'm a now crocodile, a piranha. That was like Exorcist stuff. And this video is going so quick.
What was that? She was walking on the ceiling. The show Mama, where that little girl was like spider crawling around the room. That's what that looked like to me. Oh my God, she got the power.
Oh, look at her. She got the power. So, oh my God, she got the power. And they're showing a very large woman. So to give her like some sort of like credibility or to embrace her body.
People that are overweight do feel not empowered.
It must be something in the water or that I'm my mother's daughter.
Yeah, so I don't know much about her mom. Maybe her mom has been very progressive and...
Telling her to be herself?
Yeah, something. Yeah. I don't know because I don't know her mom. Well, I know nothing about her mom.
You could definitely tell this video is about embracing whoever you are. Don't fuck with my freedom. I came back to get me
yourself. I'm nasty, I'm evil. So
that's a scar?
That's a scar from a cesarean.
Oh,
giving birth
C-section.
By a C-section.
It's pierced now?
That one is.
It's kind of creepy. It always makes me kind of cringe because I'm afraid of catching it on something.
Yeah.
I had a friend that ripped out a nipple ring.
Oh, yeah. That would hurt. Yeah.
He was climbing a fence and it ripped out.
Yeah. I've seen rings, like a chain going between nipples. But it's like that just like... Ugh. Just it'd be so easy to get it caught on something. Just rip it right out. It's like, no, I am not into pain.
I guess it's like a make lemonade kind of thing, you know? Wouldn't have a scar, pierce it.
So yeah, it's a scar, so highlight it. Instead of like be ashamed of it
embrace
or whatever.
It.
Embrace it, yeah. Must be something in the water, or that I'm a so
back up, boy. And then the whole like taboo of breastfeeding.
Yeah, which I think is bullshit. Because
it's so much healthier to breastfeed.
Yeah, it's like women should be breastfeeding their babies. I'm like all for breastfeeding babies. They get all the right stuff that a child should be getting from the beginning. It's like the whole mammalian process. That's why the tits are there to begin with, for God's sake.
It's supposed to be like incredible for their immune system.
Why in this country they've so sexualized breast, which like they are, but so weird that you can't be around someone with a breast that's doing a breast function. It's like, you might be the scary one.
Yeah. Or you just don't know biology.
Yeah. It's like, read a biology book.
Hallelujah, I'm a witch, hallelujah. I'm a witch too, because I have a third nipple.
Oh, no, I mean, like, that what? I know you don't do witchcraft, but...
If you have a third nipple, you're a witch.
And that was in medieval cultures.
Yeah, yeah.
That they would do that, and they would like, kill him.
But I don't know if they would kill a guy. It was mainly women. Maybe they would kill a guy too.
I think they would.
They would be like, that guy uses too much fairy dust.
And like, but what is it, 1 out of 22, 23 people have a third nipple?
Yeah, it's common. Swish, swish, I'm a three-point shooter. I blow through ya like a hot wind out in the bayou, yeah. Oh my God, she got the power. Tough titties.
And those are tough ones right there. They got some plastic over them.
That tongue goes.
And then that like spikes like teeth on like
that's creepy.
I'm sorry, that scene right there, that's freaking creepy to me. It's like, what was that movie?
Teeth. Yeah,
it's like
a movie called Teeth.
Yeah, this is like super edgy, and that's kind of like super creepy for me.
Yeah, that's creepy. Don't fuck with my freedom.
I came up to get me some. So I'm assuming this is a transgender individual because it says they, them.
Mm-hmm. He's good looking. I think it's a guy. Or it's them. So they are good looking. I think the point of that is I'm trying.
Yeah, trying to use the right pronoun.
I try to use the right pronoun. Not that I always get it right, but I try. A trans black individual in a wheelchair.
Covering all the bases.
That's a lot of minorities.
Yeah, can you imagine having that load of minority situations to deal with? That'd be tough.
Yeah, that's crazy. Don't fuck with my freedom. I mean, you could definitely tell that he has had, or whatever, you could tell, I'm just gonna say they because I don't know what their pronoun is. They have had a breast reduction, whatever that's called, but yeah, breast removal. Have you ever noticed how hard it is on the spot to have the right pronoun? I usually have to like backtrack a little bit. It's like, I wish I could get my brain quicker.
Well, we don't have a clue what pronoun they prefer.
That's true.
Right here.
But our language is written to be used with pronouns. Like he, she, they, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They is like a group usually. So it just takes a little time for our brains to get acclimated to it.
And that's our culture. Think about all the cultures that things are feminized and masculinized for whatever purpose. Females can't show their breasts in our culture, but males can show their chest. And here we have person born female, and then just because the female breast tissue has been removed, then it becomes okay. Which, I mean, I'm fine with it, but it's a weird thing.
Oh, it's such a weird system.
Such a weird system.
What if a guy naturally has like more breast tissue? He can still take off.
Well, how many of those have we seen?
A lot. Don't fuck with my freedom. I came up to get me some.
I'm nasty, I'm there's a balloon tits again.
Not an object.
That's something I don't get yet with this. It's like not an object, but a lot of this seems to be
objectifying
in some way to me. I don't know.
I mean, that's just what it seems. It's art, so I mean, that's our interpretation. I don't know what she actually means. I don't know if she's actually trying to objectify. I don't think that's her message, but it does come across that way to me. Ooh. I am free.
So I don't know what she identifies as. She's saying back up, back up, back up, boys. Like, this woman's body is not meant for a man. Or it's not automatically his. You can't just go for it. Maybe that has to do with all the touching, you know, men groping women. And it does happen both ways. The heteros?
De la chair.
The heroine of the chair? I think. I'm not sure.
Feminist AF.
Mm-hmm. My mama always told me that I make it, so I made it. So this is her real mom. This is her mom.
My mama always told me that I'd make it.
Yeah.
So I made it. So her mom obviously supported her being herself.
Mm-hmm. I put my back into it, my heart in it, so
This has nothing to do with like pro-life, is it? Or the right to choose? Just because of the timing?
Maybe it is. Don't fuck with my freedom. Oh my God, oh my God.
Swish, swish, motherfucker. What is that swish, swish?
Swish, swish, motherfucker. I don't know.
What does that mean? Okay, so that was obviously a song to embrace who you are, yeah. And especially for women.
Yeah.
And that you should be confident being yourself.
It is definitely edgy.
Dude, it is really
edgy. That is like probably one of the most edgy videos I've ever watched.
Wow.
It is a catchy tune, but you know, I don't guess it can be played on a lot of radio stations.
I think it'll be played. I don't know if the music video will be played. It's more the music video that's more edgy.
Yeah, but you got the swish, swish, mother. I mean, I don't know what you can play on radio.
You just
what
say
you
swish,
can.
Swish, mother, beep.
Okay. You just edit they that just word. Beep it out.
Is what yeah,
they
you do. Just beep that word out. I think the music video is more controversial than the lyrics, yeah, in my opinion.
She's going to have a hard time getting more edgy than that.
It was interesting nonetheless. Hopefully we didn't miss too much. We tried our best. If you're not subscribed to IRS, feel free to subscribe. We want our subscribers to go up. Also, hit that notification bell so you're notified of our videos. We also have a fan email. It's yrsfan@gmail.com. It allows you to send us video ideas. YRS.
And Chris.
Love you long time. My knees are killing me.